Hey guys, right, okay, here we go. So what I want to talk about is two things. One being a blog, one being a post that I did. I didn't just swear, by the way. The first thing what I want to talk about is problems. So it's a blog that I did this morning, an article that I published over onto LinkedIn, and it talks about that problems aren't stop signs, they're guidelines. And we need more of these in our life. We need more problems, but we need better quality problems. We look at problems and we think we've got to stop. We look at problems and we think we've got to quit. We look at problems and think, I can't do this any longer. But we need problems. If you don't have problems, you're not moving forward. If you don't have problems, you're stuck still. And you stood still, rather. You stood still, you're not moving forward. And if you, unless you're going forward, can you guess which way you're going? You're going back. I've just told you the answer. Ha ha! But you are, you're going back. Nothing stays still, or certainly doesn't stay still for a long time. So you need to make sure you look at getting better quality problems in your life, in your business, in your career. Because if there isn't none, you're stale. So you don't want to be stale. The second thing that I want to talk about is people who's tired. Do you know, I've got too many problems, I'm fighting these problems, I feel tired. I've got too much issues going on, I'm tired. I'm working too many hours, I'm working 9 hours, 10 hours a day. Ooh, might be 18 hours, whatever it is. I'm tired. You're not tired, you're just uninspired. Do you know, find what it is that gets you fired up. Find what it is that, you know, makes you want to jump out of bed. What is it that gets your heart pounding? You know, what is it that gets you super excited? And find a way to get there more often. Do you know, because that is what you need. You need the inspiration to go and find the things that you do, to really take that passion and turn it into profits. Do you know, take that passion that you've got sat inside you that you need to apply and take it out there. So find a way to stay motivated, find a way to find inspiration. If that's through music, if that's through, you know, picking up the phone and phoning up your best friend. Your best friend is the one that makes you feel alive. So phone them up, spend more time with them, Facebook chat them, anything that you need to do to get yourself feeling pumped and jacked up. Get that feeling and stay there. Listen, it's tough. It is tough. If it wasn't, everyone would be doing it. Very cliche, you've heard that a million times before. But it's true. And the ones that make the biggest difference are the ones that find a way to get in that absolute pinnacle state. Now, I'm not saying that you've got to be high rate, super excited. Not everybody's like that. You know, your personality type might not be someone who's jacked up, excitable, ball of energy, flying around. You might be someone who's more steady, strategic, focused, execute. Do you know, everybody's different. Find out what it is. I was having a chat with someone this morning and they were saying that, you know, they feel that they need to kind of protect themselves a little bit more. They need to have a little bit more armour. Zip it up, lock it away. But that's not being true to them. That's not being who they really are. If they're zipping themselves up, they're going to feel blocked. They're going to feel isolated. They're going to feel locked away. You need to be more of you, do you know, or certainly be more of the person you want to be. Don't be the person that's not working. Be the person that you want to be. And this is the thing that's going to allow you to move forward. Be you, but be better. A friend of mine, fantastic. Get online. Follow him online. He's doing some amazing stuff. He's called CK Golden. You've seen the videos we've done before. He did the 100 Musicians Challenge. He's down in London again. He's doing interviews. He's talking about meeting strangers, just random people, striking up conversations, and how it's making his life just flourish. And this is what we need to do is, this is his strapline, be you better. And this is what we've all got to do. We've got to try and be us, but better. Be like the person you want to be like. Be more of them. Be more like that. Be more inspired. And, you know, look for them problems. Look for the problems. And if you're in sales, my word, you need to be looking for problems. Most people I know, certainly people I've worked with in sales or I've trained in sales, they do a one-time deal and then run away as quick as possible because they don't want any problems. Damn, you're missing a trick. You need to be getting back to them, finding the problems and selling them more solutions, selling them more product, giving them more service. That's how you build loyalty. That's how you build loyalty in your client, is by selling more products. You look at Apple, I'm looking for my phone and filming on it. You look at Apple, how do they build loyalty? They keep on selling you stuff. You know, I've got everything. I've got MacBooks, iMacs, iPads, everything, Apple TV, iPhone. I think the only thing I've not got is the iWatch, because I think a watch is going to be a watch, you know. But I'm tempted to get the iWatch because it's Apple. It's a religion to me. So they build loyalty because they keep on plugging. I've got the iPod, what they call AirPods, order, special order delivery. Can't wait. March, they come in. I love it. It's a religion. That's how you build loyalty. You know, you keep selling product to your customers. But anyway, Find out what it is that gets you inspired. Find out what it is that gives you the drive, the motivation, the kick to keep going, because that is what's going to make you happy, fulfilled and successful. Because if you're doing stuff that you don't enjoy, you're miserable. And if you don't enjoy the stuff and you're miserable, your home life will follow suit. Vice versa, if your home life's uninspired and miserable, your work life's going to suffer, because these things cross over. You need to integrate them in. There's no such thing as a balance. I don't believe so anyway. This is my thought process. I think that you have to integrate the two. You can't balance them. Again, something's going to go one way or another. You live with the choices and the consequences that come with them choices. Find inspiration, find more problems, go enjoy yourself, have fun, make it happen, and have an absolutely wonderful day, life, business, month, year, everything involved. Go have fun.